Now that we saw some of the Git basic functionalities in practice, let's go a step further. If you remember, I mentioned before that many of these version control systems are actually integrated into IDEs. So what we're going to look at next is what happens if we put together Git and Eclipse, and the result is eGit, where eGit is a plugin for the Eclipse IDE that adds Git functionality to Eclipse. So let's see how that works in practice. So support for Git is available in many IDEs, including Eclipse. And if you want to get GitHub for Eclipse, you should go to eclipse.github.com and you can download the plugin. So this brings us to the plugin page, and you can use the provided URL and directions to install the plugin. In this case, we're going to copy this address. So we're going to go to Eclipse, help, install new software. We can click on add to add a new site from which to get software. We paste the location that we just copied here, and we can give it a descriptive name. In this case, I'll just call it Eclipse Git plugin. Then when I click OK, Eclipse will go and look for plugins. And as you can see, there are two options. We can select both of them and click on next. You can see that Eclipse identified a few dependencies. You can click next and accept them. You can accept the terms and conditions for the plugin and then just finish. Okay. And at this point, Eclipse will install the plugin, which might take a little bit of time, so we're just gonna speed it up. And when Eclipse is done, you will get this prompt. They'll tell you that you need to restart Eclipse for the plugin to be actually installed. And at this point, you wanna click yes, and when Eclipse restarts, you'll have your plugin. We're gonna go to the Git repository perspective that we can select here. And when we click OK, you can see that our display will change. And since we don't have any repository yet, we are provided with the possibility of adding an existing local Git repository, cloning a Git repository, or creating a new local Git repository. We're going to add an existing local repository. This is the one that we created earlier. So we'll select it and click finish. And you can see that my project is now added to the set of Git repositories. Now let's check out the project from the repository by selecting import projects. And here you can import something as an existing project. You can use a new project wizard. And in this case, I chose the option of importing as a general project. Then I click next. And as you can see, I have the project name up there and I can click finish. So now if I go to the resource perspective by clicking here, I can see that the project has been added to my set of projects. And I can see all the files within the project. Particularly if I click on the README, you can see that we have the README file that we created before. Same thing for the test file. So one thing I can do at this point is to execute different Git commands, perform different Git operations by using the team submenu in the contextual menu. And here there's several things I can do, including some advanced commands. And just to give it a shot, I'm going to try to click Show Local History. And this shows the history of the file. For example, it shows the author and it shows when it was created, when it was authored. So now let's make some changes to this file by adding some new content. Okay, I save the file and now I can see that error that indicates that my file was locally changed. So now if I go to the team menu, you can see that I have the option to add to the index to stage the file. And now I get this new label that start that shows the file is added to the index. And now at this point, I can go to the team menu again and I can actually commit the file by selecting the corresponding entry. This allows me to enter the commit message. Exactly in the same way which I could do that from the command line with the textual editor. And after I put the comment there, I can actually commit. And now if we look at the history view, we can see here that we have a new version for the file that we just modified, and we can also see the commit comment. And at this point, if we had a remote repository, we could push our changes to that remote repository as well, again, using the team submenu in the contextual menu. And speaking of remote repositories, what we're going to see next is how to use GitHub repositories, which are remote repositories that are hosted on GitHub.